So you want to insulate your home, but should you use fiberglass, cellulose, or spray foam? Let's talk about it. Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to be discussing the options of fiberglass, cellulose, and spray foam, and which is best for your home. Before we dive into this, please go below, make that thumbs up blue for us. Thanks. So the first point of comparison we're going to be discussing is effectiveness. And when we're looking at fiberglass, cellulose, and spray foam and comparing which one is the most effective for your home, well, there's a few things to look at. You know, we think about R value, right? Which product has the most R value? And kind of along the lines of R value, which product and or material has the best thermal resistance? Or are there other things to keep in mind that would make one more effective over the others? So if we lay this out in a good, better, best type situation, fiberglass would be a good option. It is good enough. You can effectively insulate a home with fiberglass. There are some added steps that you have to keep in mind. You have to take some measures beforehand to make sure you get a seal and things like that, make sure it's laid in properly, but it can be good enough. Cellulose could be looked at as a better option. It does have a stronger thermal resistance. You're typically looking at a higher R value, and it can last longer, again, depending on some situations. So cellulose would be a better alternative. Whereas spray foam in pretty much any category will be the best option. The reason being is its effectiveness comes in place with, yes, it has a really good R value, it has an outstanding thermal resistance, but it also has some added benefits. One being air seal, which we'll talk about in just a moment. So let's talk about air seal. First off, why is having an air seal important in your insulation material? Well, simply put, heat transfers much, much faster through air movement than through conductive heat loss, which is what R value measures. So if we keep that in mind, we can then appreciate how important it is to establish an air seal on your building envelope. So if we keep in mind that spray foam does provide that air seal, it helps us understand why that is looked at as the best option. If we go down the line at cellulose, cellulose does not provide an air seal. However, it does have more of a thermal resistance capability than fiberglass, and there are some measures that you can put in place to help fiberglass and cellulose establish an air seal. So when you're looking at these two, again, you can establish air seal on your walls, attic, that sort of thing, crawl space, any area of the house. However, it's not in the material itself. You will have to take some outside measurements to make sure you have the air seal around the house if you're going to use fiberglass, a good option, or a better option, cellulose. But again, the best thing to do would be to use a material like spray foam that has an air seal with the material. So the next thing we're going to talk about is maintenance. What type of maintenance do these three materials require for your home? Well, let's look at fiberglass first. Fiberglass over time will break down and you will need to replace or add to it. Specifically, let's talk about your attic for this topic, because this is the easiest area for you to get in and add to or maintain that material. As your fiberglass breaks down, like I said, you will need to add layers to your fiberglass, whether it's blown in or if you have rolled bats up in the attic area. The other thing is you will have to maintain venting. Because if you're going to use fiberglass, most likely you're going to have it on the floor of the attic, which is fine. Just keep in mind that will add to the maintenance level. Moving on to cellulose, again, you will have the same level of maintenance. You will have to check that out, make sure it has not broken down, and eventually you will have to add to it over the years. One thing with cellulose or any type of blown-in material is it has a tendency to drift or bank inside your attic because you will have airflow. Keep in mind, we mentioned you're going to have venting if you have a blown-in material on the floor. That venting introduces airflow into the attic space. That airflow can push the blown-in material up against walls or any type of structure inside the attic space. That pushing can leave low spots on the floor, which can leave you short on insulation where you need it. So you will need to go up into the attic and maintain those blown-in materials. You may have to re-rake, and eventually you will have to add layers to it. Keep that in mind. Moving on to spray foam, you will not have to maintain this material. It is a one-and-done solution where once it is sprayed on, it is typically warranted to stay in place and stay at that effectiveness for the lifetime of the building. You will never have to go in and add layers to it because it's broken down or anything like that. Touching on venting real quick, when it comes to spray foam, yes, you can put spray foam on the floor of your attic just like you would blown-in material. However, it's typically recommended to put spray foam on the roof deck going to a ventless system. So that's just another thing to keep in mind, another measure where spray foam can go to a totally free maintenance option. So the last thing we're going to look at is cost. Of course, this will always be a factor when we're looking at any type of material or project for our home. So if we're looking at fiberglass, fiberglass is by far going to be the least expensive material. It is available at pretty much any big box store. You can get this almost anywhere, and like I said, it will usually be your lowest cost. Cellulose bumping up, you can find this at big box stores. You can use this as a DIY option, so that is available as well. However, usually you're going to have a contractor involved, so you're stepping up in price, you're stepping up in effectiveness and a lot of other things like we've talked about. But with those additions in effectiveness comes additions in cost, so keep that in mind. And of course, spray foam will always be the most expensive option. So keep in mind, you're having a company come in, you're having a contractor come in with a truck and trailer usually, you're getting a warranty that's lasting lifetime of the building in most cases. So all of those additional things will lead up to spray foam being the most expensive option. So these are some things to keep in mind when you're comparing fiberglass, cellulose, spray foam to insulate your home. If you want to learn more about comparing fiberglass, cellulose, and spray foam for insulating your home, please check out the link below. Don't forget, subscribe to this channel and ring that bell to see all of our notifications.